What am I gonna do here?
You look really stressed out. What's going on?
I'm working on this project and I'm just running out of room. I've already laid out my main breaker, the contactors, and the five drives, but I still need to add two starters. I don't know what to do.
Well, actually, Eaton has a solution where you can run multiple motors with one drive.
Oh, that's awesome. Can you please show me?
Yeah, sure. So here, you can actually eliminate these four drives, and you've just gained space back for the rest of your equipment, since you only need one drive. Yeah, and then here are your one line changes.
Welcome to Eaton's Power Systems Experience Center. Here at the Experience Center, our engineers provide a safe, controlled environment for training, testing, and demonstrating full-scale power system problems and solutions. In this video, we will discuss medium voltage drives and even show you a special configuration where you can run multiple motors using one drive. Let's get started. What is a variable frequency drive? A variable frequency drive, also known as an adjustable frequency drive, is used for controlling a motor or pump by varying the frequency. The flexibility of VFDs to speed up or slow down motors is especially beneficial in systems like HVAC, manufacturing, pumps, and compressors versus fixed speed motors. Medium voltage drives are used for running very large motor loads for up to 10,000 horsepower or more in industrial applications. Drives offer process control and significant energy savings. In fact, in typical industrial applications, less than 3% of the total cost of ownership of a motor is the initial cost. In most cases, 80 to 90% of the total cost of the motor is from energy usage. This is why using drives is so important. What is considered a medium voltage drive? Voltage classifications vary by manufacturer and standard. Generally speaking, medium voltage is defined as 1,000 to 69,000 volts. Medium voltage drives are typically applied at 2,400 or 4,160 volts. Why use a medium voltage drive? You're probably asking yourself, why is it necessary to run drives at such high voltages? I'm used to seeing low voltage VFDs like 480 volts. Why not use those? Well, remember the basic electrical power equation, KVA equals voltage times current? This means that for a fixed power level, the voltage and current are inversely proportional. The higher the supply voltage of the drive, the less current it will draw. Once you reach a horsepower rating of 300 horsepower or above, or thousands of horsepower for industrial applications, the difference in current draw between medium voltage versus low voltage is significant. Let's look at the numbers. A good rule of thumb is that KVA is roughly equal to horsepower. Say 100 horsepower equals 100 kVA. Here's a full equation for three-phase power. kVA equals volts times current times the square root of 3. A 1,000 horsepower motor operating at 480 volts has a current draw of 1,204 amps versus 139 amps at 4,160 volts. This is significant, almost 1/10 the current draw when running a medium voltage for this example. Operating at a low voltage requires a motor to draw very high current, all the way through the power system, down to and including the motor. This increases system losses and requires very large conductors, increasing your costs. At medium voltage, the current is decreased significantly. Wire sizes can be reduced and losses are minimized. While we're talking numbers, let's highlight another benefit of using variable frequency drives. Drives offer a very high power factor, which is the ratio of working power versus apparent power, further reducing the overall current required to run the motor and system losses. Medium voltage drives can be used for pumps, motors, compressors, and fans in hard duty industries like HVAC, pulp and paper, petrochemical, and water wastewater. How does it work? In general, variable frequency drives convert AC voltage to DC and then back to variable frequency AC voltage. This is how they can change or vary the speed of the motor by varying the frequency. In general, components of a medium voltage drive are an isolation switch, fuses, contactors, rectifier converting AC to DC, DC bus, and an inverter converting DC to AC. Considerations when choosing a medium voltage drive. There are various design and installation considerations to think about when you're choosing a medium voltage drive, aside from obvious system specifications like voltage or horsepower rating. There are other factors to consider. When it comes to medium voltage drives, you need to think about safety, harmonics, footprint, and reliability. Safety. Think about personnel interacting or maintaining this medium voltage equipment. There are various ways to protect them. By having low voltage compartments that house control and meter wiring that are separate from medium voltage compartments, having mechanical means to prevent entry into energized compartments, such as keyed cabinet doors or cart keys, having isolation switches that disconnect line power to each compartment, adding e-stops to each compartment or motor circuit, and finally, consider arc-resistant gear to protect from arc flash hazards. Harmonics. Variable frequency drives inherently add harmonics into the electrical system. This happens in the process of converting AC to DC voltage. Here at the PSEC, we can show you a medium voltage drive that has an integrated isolation transformer with a 24 pulse front end design that mitigates harmful harmonics. The transformer also has a patented soft mag pre-charge technology to eliminate the inrush current. We backfeed voltage on the secondary side of the isolation transformer, which allows us to eliminate the inrush current during the magnetization process of the transformer. Footprint. With greater voltage comes greater footprint. Most of the time, medium voltage drives are placed in an electrical room or even an e-house. Depending on the room size and layout, footprint quickly becomes a challenge when designing the layout of a medium voltage lineup. You may have a square-shaped room with an aisle between two sets of gear, or a long rectangle that allows for equipment to sit side by side. It is important to consider how you will connect the gear, either through cabling or bus. Did you know that globally, Eaton is the industry first to offer an integrated lineup of medium voltage motor control and switchgear products connected to a common bus? All types of motor starters, load brake switches, integrated medium voltage VFDs, main and feeder breakers can be integrated into an amp guard integrated control gear. These sections can be integrated together for limitless configurations, not just for medium voltage control, but for distribution as well. All of this saves you valuable footprint for your application. Finally, reliability is a very important consideration when choosing medium voltage drives. As we've discussed, medium voltage drives are typically used in high power industrial applications, meaning that these drives will have to be suitable for very harsh environments with airborne contaminants. Look for equipment features like tin-plated copper bus, conformal coated circuit boards, and enclosure gasketed with removable and cleanable filters, suitable for harsh environment applications. Here at the PSEC, we can show you how we have taken reliability a step further with our medium voltage drive, the SC9000. Like with cooling, for example, there are various methods for cooling a VFD in the market. One option is through forced air by blowing air straight into the components. Alternatively, the components are cooled with a circulating water system. For the inverter, we use a heat pipe patented technology using thin pipes with water in a completely enclosed system, making it maintenance-free. This cooling system is 10 times more efficient than regular forced air systems in the market. Furthermore, in the inverter section, we have developed encapsulated power poles. The power poles are encapsulated inside a silicon-based material, making it robust in harsh environments and are field serviceable too. Lastly, the SC9000 drive has the highest mean time between failure of 111,000 plus hours before failure on the inverter. This is the highest in the market due to the reduced number of components and simplicity of design, making it very reliable. Hardy, our engineering services specialist, has been installing and servicing medium voltage drives for many years. He's going to show you how you can use one drive to bring multiple motors online with our synchronous transfer demo.
Here at the PSEC, we have our medium voltage SC9000 drive close coupled with medium voltage amp guard contactors and starters to create the synchronous transfer scheme. Synchronous transfer systems help industrial facilities maximize the capital efficiency of their systems by controlling multiple motors with one variable frequency drive. Eaton's medium voltage drive, or MVD, sync transfer configuration combines Eaton's SC9000 drive and Eaton's medium voltage control gear. The double bus design, drive output, isolation, motor select, bypass, and PLC control cabinet are close coupled under a common utility power bus with no external power cabling required, providing a compact design and added reliability. The drive uses an integrated main bus system. The main bus runs on the top of the drive sections, which can be close coupled with starters and other medium voltage amp guard equipment, as you can see here. This saves the customer from having cables in and cables out or conduit going through each of the starters or drives for medium voltage motor control. A second 1200 amp MVD bus is located above the main bus, adding only 6 inches of additional height to the system. The basic principle of synchronous transfer control is to adjust the drive output voltage, frequency, and phase to match the utility. By matching these parameters, the drive system can transfer a motor from the drive output to the utility or main bus in a bumpless manner and through closed transition. The drive and PLC system are programmed to start, stop, or control a single motor, as well as sync up or sync down a motor to the main bus or utility bus one at a time. The drive accomplishes this by synchronizing the drive output to 60 Hz, then placing or removing the motor from the utility bus, matching utility frequency of 60 Hz. Upon system startup, the drive and MVD bus are energized. The PLC closes the drive output contactor and the designated motor select contactor, and it starts the drive, allowing power to be directed to the desired motor for operation. The designated motor can now be operated at variable speed through the VFD as needed. When an additional motor is required, the PLC will send the sync up command to the drive. The drive adjusts its output to match the line voltage, frequency, and phase angle. Once the drive output and line are synchronized, the system will transfer the motor from the drive output to the utility by closing the motor bypass contactor, then opens the MVD output contactor, and finally the motor select contactor to accomplish the closed transition. Once synchronization is complete, the drive is now available to perform one of the three tasks: sync up a motor to the utility bus, sync down a motor from the utility bus, operate the motor through the drive. So when would you use a sync transfer scheme? This synchronous transfer scheme is especially valuable in water and wastewater, in oil and gas, midstream, and industrial processes where all of the motors are run at full load and one of the motors needs to be run at a variable speed. Here are a few specific examples for water supply and demand control. In water and wastewater applications, say there were heavy, prolonged rains, the city's wastewater pump system would bring pump one online. As the rains continue, the drive would increase the first pump to full speed, transfer it to the 60 Hz utility bus, and proceed to turn pump two online. Once pump two is online, if additional pumping is needed, the drive would bring pump two to full speed and sync up pump two to the utility bus. Then the drive is available to start pump three if the rain continues, and so on. Or alternatively, when supplying a water tank or well with clean water, MVD could individually sync up two motors to full speed and run them through the utility bus, and then run the third pump through variable frequency control for level control. In oil and gas, midstream, pipelines carry crude throughout long distances. As they move different volumes of crude oil and grades, they can benefit from using one drive to put as many motors online as they may need for the demand of their process at any given time. For example, they may operate at higher volumes of crude oil through the pipelines, or they may change the grade of the oil and need to pump at different viscosities. And in the food industry, for refrigeration, a drive can run two refrigeration compressors. The drive syncs up the first compressor to full speed, and the second one runs through variable frequency control to control the temperature and keep the product at the perfect temperature.
If you want to learn more about medium voltage drives, our closed transition sync transfer scheme for multiple motors, and design considerations for medium voltage systems, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to one of Eaton's Power Systems Experience Centers today.